Well, hello, good people. Mark Holmes here, and as always, I want to say thank you all for watching, commenting, subscribing, and being part of the Joe Boo Sports Report. Without you guys, as well as you ladies, you know that this literally does not work. You know, I woke up at home this morning after being in Harrisburg yesterday, and I'm back here at the Red Brick House. And so, we got all kinds of things that are going on, apparently. And as I get unpacked again from not being here for a few days or so, and get everything put back together here in the studio, we have something that's kind of interesting, because this actually was a rumor that I missed yesterday that Rich Eisen was talking about. Now, I will say, one thing that you want people not to know is what your plans are when you are trying to negotiate and do things. If the Cowboys go out and they say, you know, we want to get such and such player, then a team that has that player, or that player knows they really want me, that gives them negotiating power. You know, just like my friend, Bobby, who's a car salesman, you know, and I said to him, I said, because he's been doing a whole lot of car sales and stuff, I said, so you, when you know somebody has to get to work tomorrow and their car's broke down, what happens? He's like, the advantage is all on me. They're desperate to make a deal, as opposed to somebody who can just walk away, which is very true. So we've so far seen the Cowboys do absolutely positively nothing. And we have killed them for doing absolutely positively nothing. Now, I will say that we were doing the same thing last year, and they did make a trade for Stephon Gilmore and for Brandon Cooks. Now, those aren't major moves, but they are moves in themselves. And so, here's one that would be interesting if it actually does work out. So, we've heard that Minnesota is open to the possibility of Kirk Cousins coming back, but we've also heard that the Atlanta Falcons are ready to make a deal for Kirk Cousins. And so, if that does happen, then the Minnesota Vikings don't have a quarterback. And this is where this rumor actually sounds kind of fitting. Let me play Rich Eisen so he can explain it, and then we'll come back and talk about it some more.
This is where
I'm ready.
Okay. Let me give it the proper setup here.
Come on.
Let me give it the proper setup here. Boy, do people love to talk at the combine. And this is the chattiest of the cattiest groups of people, because they're all there. They're all there, scouts and assistants and this and that. And you see them in a bar, you see them in a restaurant, you see them on the street, you see them in a lobby. And after, like, hey, when the conversation usually goes, hey, when'd you get here? Oh, when are you leaving? How long are you here for? People ask me, like, how long I'm here for. I'm like, I turn the lights off here, man.
I'm here till it's over.
It's all right. But boy, do people love to tell you what's going on, what they've heard, to see, have you heard the same thing? Can you believe what I've heard? So a lot gets poured into my ear gate.
Yes.
And normally I don't deal in rumor, but you guys want it so badly, I'm blaming it on you.
So bad.
I placed my Medill School of Journalism degree from the esteemed Institution of Higher Learning, Northwestern University. I place it aside, and I give you my top five rumors that I've heard at the combine. Look, here is my rumors. Latest version of it. Hit it.
High five. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Rich's top five.
All righty then. Here we go. Number five on the list involves the Minnesota Vikings, who, as you know, are sitting on the clock, 11th overall. Kirk Cousins is going to be a free agent unless they get a deal done in time. We had the coach, Kevin O'Connell, in our booth this weekend, and I asked him, it's funny, he said to me the day before when I saw him, he goes, you get one Kirk Cousins question. Did I tell you this on the air?
Yeah.
Okay. You get one Kirk Cousins question. So my question was, what are you willing to share? Where do things stand right now? And he was very honest. He said he thinks that Cousins is a process guy, and he's going to go through the process of free agency. Mm-hmm. And so before he said that, I heard this rumor that a possible salve at quarterback for the Minnesota Vikings is a native of the state, and his name is Trey Lance.
Whoa!
Trey Lance is a possible solve for the Vikings. Now, the Cowboys picked up, kept him on as the roster long enough for him to get a bonus. So they're paying the money to keep him. Mm-hmm. And they, as you know, got him for a five. I'm just wondering if the Vikings flip him a three.
It's a four.
A Friday night pick? Do they go ahead and do that?
Whoa.
That Trey Lance, as we all know, you also have to pick up a fifth-year option. I'm just saying.
Wow.
That a possibility out there, kids from the state, as we all know.
That would be an interesting one.
And that might be an answer. And see what he's got. And go to work and say, how does Justin Jefferson sound to you? Because they're going to give him the bag. That's for sure. Mm-hmm. So that's number five on my top five rumors that I heard at the combine. Number four involves the quarterback depth chart in the draft. And I'll just...
I'll leave it there. That's enough right there. Because I haven't even heard. I just, you know, sat down, got my computer in here, testing everything and all that. And I saw, juiciest NFL rumors. If that's number five, I can't wait to get to all the way to number one. But number one will be that the Cowboys aren't going to re-sign Dak Prescott. And we'll deal with that, of course, you know, until the Cowboys do something. And this is where I say, the Cowboys, how many times have we heard the Cowboys say that, you know, they're not going to reset the market, or Dak's got to leave money on the table, or Zeke who, that they always act like they can live without a player. So I feel like the Cowboys are doing what they always doing, which is if you can't win, be media darlings, you know, be always in the headlines. But if the Cowboys were able to take Trey Lance and turn him into a third round pick from their fourth round pick, and understand where our fourth round pick would be is late. It's almost a fifth round. If they were able to get like Minnesota's third, that would actually be like one and a half ahead. You does that make sense? Because, you know, at 26, you're talking about a fourth round pick being like 120 for us. Well, if you look at Minnesota's, because they didn't make the playoffs and things, it's going to be a lot higher up than what ours would be. So, you know, now you're talking about, you know, maybe like, let me look it up. Minnesota's picks. Let's see if I can find it real quick. Minnesota's draft picks 2024. Let's see. What are their picks? Their third round pick. Vikings are one of four teams to finish 7-10, but tiebreakers result in the Falcons with the eighth pick, Bears 9, Jets 10 being awarded higher spots. Minnesota select from the 11th spot three times in franchise history. So 11, 42, and, oh, they don't have a third-round pick. Okay, so much for that. They have a second-round pick at 42, and then they have a fourth-round pick from Detroit in their fourth-round pick. So it would have to be something other than that. So they don't actually have a third-round pick. But if you were able to get even, I mean, let's say this, even if you ended up getting their fourth-round pick, and let's say their sixth-round pick, their fourth-round pick, from Detroit, well, their fourth-round pick would be a lot higher than your fourth-round pick. And if you can get a second one in there, might not be a bad thing. So this is an interesting thought, if that could happen, because one other ramifications, let's see. Over the cap, Dallas Cowboys. Let's see what Trey Lance's is a $5.3 million, and if they did him as a post June 1st trade, they would save that $5.3 million and maybe get an extra draft pick. It's a pre-June 1st trade. Same thing. Pre-June 1st, that would make 100%. If you could get another draft pick and get another $5 million in cap relief, $5 million could be a free agent. An extra draft pick? I'm just saying, if you're talking about going all in and not taking any risk, there you go. You can save yourself $5.3 million, and you can get another draft pick. I could say, okay. And then you hold on to Cooper Rush, who is a much smaller cap hit than Trey Lance. So we'll see if anything comes of that, but that's one of those ones that I kind of like. Of course, the Dak Prescott haters will say, of course you do, because you know he's better than Dak and you want to get him off the roster. No, I'm trying to get some players that are going to be on the field to try and make this team better, because $5 million is pretty close to being able to get Derrick Henry. So